Right, guys, here it is as it's happening. I'm just transferring, well, I'm converting one file into another format. I'm going to be uploading this soon, and it's on this guy here. All right, it's the KAM TRI260 SD FSCAN. So what I'm going to do is just put the camera sort of there-ish. All right, that is an SD card slot. If I just put it like that, is that any better? No. Okay. Ah, dear. Right. Right, what are we looking at here? Well, basically, this guy is it's a bit of a beast, actually. This is the idiot-proof thing. Sound DMX, SD card there, or PC mode. So in other words, if you've got that plugged into your PC, voila, then you can set the programs. SD card, on the other hand, it uses, I think it's FAT16 files, just you have to bear with me on that. But what you can do is, logically, you go on your PC and you can, you know, form a decent show on the PC. Then you can put that show onto the SD card, put it in there, like that. And then make sure you've got that pressed to SD, and you're good to go. And also with this, look at that. I mean, all right, it's only a tiny thing. Actually, get the damn thing out for a start. Comes with its own key. Now, that will not open your front door. What it will do, though, it'll stop Muppets from playing around with this when you're not there. So I'm just going to put that in there. I'm going to pause the camera, turn the lights off, and let's have a look at it in the dark. Right, here we go. Let's just have a look at it from all angles. Give you a general idea. And in relation to size, that's a CD. There you go. That's pretty cool. I mean, that's a heart, and you can make out that that is a heart shape. Very clever. I think what makes this slightly different to a lot of other lasers is that this is, I suppose what we're doing here is we're getting onto the sort of almost semi-professional level. You know, a lot of lasers are, not, I'm not saying they're necessarily cheap and cheerful, but they do exactly what they say on the tin. This, on the other hand, takes it to the next level. I mean, again, this is very good. It's powerful, but I mean, there are some lasers out there that are tens of thousands of pounds. You know, this is sort of dealing in milliwatts, and there are actual lasers out there that deal in watts. And if you consider, let's say, for example, your power output of your speaker is, say, 500 watts. And then, let's say you hear of a laser that is 1 and 2 watts, you'll think, well, that's not very powerful. But 1 and 2 watts, where lasers are concerned, are, like, hyper-powerful and quite often have to be water-cooled. I mean, you can hear in the background that noise. Not that. The noise from that is the fan cooling it down. And like I said, some lasers are so powerful they have to be cooled literally by being continually injected with water. I mean, of course, logically, the water doesn't go over the laser itself. It runs around it to cool the whole unit down. Well, not the actual whole unit, but the laser diode itself. Now that is sweet. Yes. Very nice. So there you go. Right, there you go. And bearing in mind, I've got the lights on as well. Right, this guy plays back. This is, I think it's ILDA laser shows through the PC interface and the SD card. And then it's compatible with the KAM LC01 laser software. And also with this as well, you can program it in to do text, so you can do, you know, happy birthday Dorothy, or, you know, anything really. There you go, it's the Laser TRI 260 SD FSCAN. practice and enjoy. And as ever, I'll put a lickable clink, take you straight to the KAM website.